While we're on the subject, abstinence-only sex education, that's just creepy. That really is. You know what I'm talking about, you know, where they go into the schools and they tell the kids don't have sex till you're married and even then don't enjoy it. And I don't care if you have made a personal, individual, independent decision to save yourself until marriage. Unless you're someone I fancy. But it's none of my business, it's none of theirs. Because since it got brought in, and this is a beautiful statistic, because there was a study done in one of the areas, and there was an increase in the rate of teenage virginity, which is what they wanted. But there was also a decrease in the rate of teenage anal virginity. I know, because they don't tell them that's not allowed, because they can't bring themselves to discuss it. And the kids think, yeah, loophole. So to speak. That one's okay, Ernie, that one's fine. Jesus doesn't mind a bit of bumming. You've seen the pictures, he's not averse to suffering. But that's the thing, they are geniuses, they're so good at marketing themselves. Because their main argument is logically foolproof. They go into the schools and they say, kids, abstinence is the safest form of contraception. Of course it is. Of course abstinence is the safest form of contraception. Staying at home is the safest form of transport. People with anorexia rarely get food poisoning. Cigarette companies are actually, they're another group of people who are amazing at marketing themselves. They are evil geniuses. This is how good they are at marketing tobacco as a product. I have a favorite brand of cigarette, and a second favorite, and a third choice. I don't smoke. I have never smoked, but I have an opinion on it. And I know I'm not the only non-smoker who's done that before, who's had some smokers offer around some cigarettes and you thought, oh, that's a good one. I like that brand that I've never tasted in my life. No, you don't. You just like the marketing and the packaging that goes with it. Like, it's amazing how much marketing affects you. I've got tampon preferences. Just in case. It's never been an issue. But if it does become one, I know which way I'm going. And I'm not going supermarket own brand. Because with this kind of a problem, quality counts. I'd imagine.